fishing adventure. Here at George Airport. Rolled off my rim, I cleared customs, and I'm off to Victoria for a long day's catching. So,
this is the air version of our Catchmobile. Instead of driving in the Mazda Miata, today we flew on Air Canada Jazz. I've landed in Victoria and I'm eager to go off finding some geocaches. Let's go. Here I am waiting at the bus stop. The city bus is going to be my next Catchmobile, and as soon as it comes, I'm going to drop my stuff and go caching.
I've arrived at my first geocaching stop on Vancouver Island. I'm in the beautiful community of Sydney, and here I found a perfect geocache for my grandson, Jordan. He loves this kind of thing. This is the kind of geocache where you don't find a log, but you look for some information, and you email it to the cache owner. So I'm going to turn off the video, find that information, log the cache, and...
Welcome to my power pole. Guess where the cache is? Well, you gotta find it.
Well, I've been in Sydney for maybe half hour, 45 minutes. I'm already on my third find. The last one, you saw the cache owner. He has a business right by the cache. Now I'm at this cache somewhere in this tree. The hint is branch out. I'm going to look, but I do know that the last couple of logs were D and F, so it might have been muggle, but I'm going to give it a try.
Right now I'm looking at the location of the next in my series of Sydney caches. I've already found this one. It was actually harder to roll it up and put it back in its container because it was another one of those bison tubes. It was harder to rehide it than it was to find it. If the cache had eyes, it would be looking out on this beautiful view of Sydney Harbour. Look at this guy. Isn't he cool? I wonder what he's looking at. I'm gonna go see.
So here I am with my pirate buddy. He's a heavyweight. Kieran would love this guy, and I'm looking out to see what he can see. In a moment I'll turn the camera out so you can see. Turns out that this guy is right near a cache I'm looking for, and he's also looking for the fish market that I'm looking for so I can get some cans of smoked tuna. So this is my lucky day, I found the right place.
Here are the cormorants that my pirate buddy was looking at. And I'm just going to pan over and you can see here is the fish market. And somewhere down along the chain is the next cache I'm looking for. Alright, you see this seagull. It's as if he were guarding the cache. I can tell you that he is very close. I'm here at the satellite fish market. I'm about to sign the log, go in and buy some tuna, and move on.
So now here I am in Sydney. It's a beautiful sunny day, and I'm on the quest for part two of a three-part multi called Seniors Gone Wild. I found the first clue. It was by the fish market, and now I'm looking for the second one called Seniors Gone Wild Condo Crazy. If I find all three micros, it will give me a hint to the fourth one. Meanwhile, I'm sitting here in the sun. It's a beautiful day. I'm looking at the fish market. It didn't have the smoked tuna I wanted, and I'm going to show you the sculpture of a diver, my newfound Sydney friend. So here he is, my wooden sea diving buddy. Maybe he's seen the clue to the next cache. I wonder. I'm off.
As you can see, I'm at University of Victoria, and this place is just full of rabbits. More rabbits than students. I almost tripped on one. This rabbit is guarding a cache, and I'll be heading up this path in search of a cache called Judgment Day.
Well, here I am sitting at the Victoria Airport on my way back home to Prince George. I spent a very busy day caching here. I cached throughout Sydney by the sea, and I hopped the bus and went to the area around University of Victoria. I got about 6 out of 10 caches and saw some interesting wildlife, interesting countryside. So
So that's about it for caching Victoria.